novel is based on a young guy who's about late 16, he's going on 17 years of age, and his mother has died, and him and his father have had a hard time. Basically, they've had a hard time since his mother died. His sister had already died. It's a tumour or cancer that is basically transmitted through the female line. And so the girl died when she was maybe 12. And now, several years later, the mother has died also of the same cancer. So it's been a very traumatic period for the boy and for his father. And they've been going on kind of just having difficulty together and not able really, I suppose, to discuss grief or to fight their way through the grief. And the son, to some extent, has been taking care of the father, and the father's been taking care of the son. This is really what's been happening. But the young guy, Murdo, he's a musician. In other words, he's a young artist. And he's a good one in the sense that he's not like, he plays in a band, plays in a couple of bands. This is part of his background within the story. And after his mother was taken ill, he stopped playing music. By the time he goes to the States, he goes to the States because his uncle, or his father's uncle, lives in Alabama. And it's the home of, people will know it's the home of bluegrass music and great musicians like Doc Watson, Hazel Dickens, and Everly Brothers, contemporary people. This is a real music stronghold. But it's also, there's the other aspect of Alabama is the far right fundamentalist side of it. So they end up in Alabama, which is around Huntsville in the novel. And from there, there are certain escapades, you might say, befall Murdo because of his, for him, music is a universal thing. There is no race and no sectarianism. There is nothing like that at that level of, as a young musician, young artist, you just want kind of to be involved in what you do. So he meets up with this African-American family, but it's not a typical African-American family. It appears to be, but really it's not. It comes from a very old French-speaking African culture, which is a Creole language, a Creole culture. He wants to play in a band. That's really what he wants to do. And he experiences the excitement of that when he meets up with this great old musician, Queen Monzier. So that's the essential story. And she invites him to come and do a gig with him. And in a sense, if you could call there a plot, and I'm not really very good at plots, you know, but if there is a plot, then the plot probably concerns, like, how does this young guy escape from his father and family in Alabama and get to this tremendously exciting music festival in Lafayette, which is a festival. I mean, it's a regular annual festival. It's on every year in April, which I've been to. It's a real exciting thing. It does remind me of the one in Lorient, because accordion bands and Gaelic musicians and so on, conjunto, and anywhere where accordion is important, they all go to this festival. It's very exciting. So that's where Murdo wants to find a way to get there. He knows his father won't take him, borrow money from his father in order to make a trip. And by hook or by crook, he gets to Lafayette to take part in this, and that's the essential story. My own teenage background at the same age as Murdo in the story, for me it was the visual arts. So when I was when I would be maybe 14, 15, 16, I became very excited by basically French art. So, and I read and devoured French art. So I would read biographies of Cezanne, Gauguin, and Modigliani, and whoever I could. And this is what I was very aware of as a teenager. At that age, I thought I would be maybe, I thought, oh, I'll be a painter. But then when I was about 18 or 19, I realized I was never painting. So how could you be a painter if you didn't paint, you know? So when I got a little older, I started to read Zola and became, I didn't realize how important Zola was to me until I was older. I'd read so much between Zola and Balzac. Zola and Balzac were, and then I stopped reading. After I got sickened by it. It was like, no more, no more. And I gave up halfway through reading a novel by Zola, and I've never read anything since. But it had such a powerful influence on me because of how he used language. He used language in this way that I realized that my very first novel was very influenced by Zola, to the point where it is like an exercise in naturalism or a social realism. And I realized Zola's very, very good as a tutor for writers, because you really learn how to be absolutely precise, never say more than necessary and so on. There are dangers, and it's good to read other writers too and realize that you don't have to do this. You don't have to end up like Rob Gree or some of it. You don't have to do that. You can do other more exciting things. That's the way I would look at it. So it wasn't so much music, but music was very important to me as a young person, but not as an artist, a young artist. It was the visual arts was what was important.